Resetting of Angular forms sounds and looks like quite a simple operation, isn't it? However, in many scenarios, its behavior might be very surprising. For example, when you reset your root form group model, then after resetting, you realize that the status of the form is still submitted. From this video, you will learn everything you have to know about the form resetting using reactive forms in Angular. You will see how the resetting logic is implemented and works under the hood. My name is Dmytro Mrzhensky, and I'm really happy to see you on my channel about advanced Angular development. So please continue watching until the end, because we are getting started to learn a lot of cool stuff. Very often we need to reset the form to some certain state after we submitted the form, or at some other point in time. By form resetting, I mean not only resetting the values of form controls to some certain state, but also resetting form control and form group validation statuses and making the form pristine and untouched. This lesson is fully dedicated exclusively to this topic. Let's get back to the code and implement a form reset when the form is submitted. So I will jump to the method on submit and implement some resetting functionality. Here might be multiple strategies how the form can be reset. The strategy number one, you reset form values to null, you reset validation statuses and make the form with all its controls untouched and pristine. It is the easiest strategy, and basically everything you need to do is to take the form instance, or actually the form group that represents the form, and call the method reset. That's it. Now if I save it and go to the browser, and of course, once I fill out the form to pass my validators, then when I submit it, you can see that all form controls got values null, all my validation statuses were reset, all form controls got ng-pristine and ng-untouched statuses, but except, by the way, the ng-submitted status, and I will come back to it in a minute. Additionally, I would like to highlight that not all controls were reset to null. The fields, which were configured as non-nullable, they were reset to their initial values, likewise the year of birth field. But before we move to the second strategy, let's figure out why the ng-submitted status wasn't reset, though theoretically it should be. The thing is that here we reset the state of the form group model. The form group model by itself doesn't necessarily represent a form, right? It might be just a nested group, and that's why the model doesn't have any properties and methods that are responsible for things like mark as submitted or something like that. The submission state belongs to the directive that represents the form, and in reactive forms, it is the form group directive. If we jump to the source code, we will see here the property submitted, and exactly this property will read the ng control status group directive when it attaches or removes the corresponding CSS classes to the host element, to the form host element. But let's quickly get back to the source code of the form group directive and check how and where the submitted state can be changed. And it can happen in a couple of places. The first place is obviously when the form is submitted. So here this property is set to true, which makes the ng-control-status-group directive apply ng-submitted CSS class to the form element. And the second place where submitted state can change is when the form is reset. And here you can also see that it is set back to false, which causes the removal of the ng-submitted CSS class from the form element. And as far as I know, at the moment of the recording of this video, you cannot change this submitted status anywhere else except those two methods. This is because submitted property is exposed as a read-only, so you cannot change it from the outside. Only those two methods can change this property value using that dirty hack. So it means if you want to reset the form and it is important for you that the ng-submit status should be reset as well, then you should call this method, fortunately this public one. And you should call this method instead of the reset method of the form group model. So what we can do, we can get a reference to the form group directive instance via view child decorator, just like that. And then instead of directly resetting the model, I delegate it to the reset method from the directive. And once I change that, I can go to the browser again. And again, I'm going to fill out the form. And when I submit the form right now, you can see that all values and statuses for form controls have been reset, as well as ng submit status for the form. So it works. However, I should mention as well that my current approach has also a drawback, and namely, unlike the reset method of the form model, this one isn't type safe. At least at the moment when I record this video. There, the value type, as you can see, is any. So if you will do some typo, TypeScript will not be able to give you a hint at the build time. So keep in mind that. But let's move forward and have a look at the second strategy. And the second strategy is when you reset everything like in the first strategy, but you want to remind the form control values as it was entered by the user. In this case, you would need to use the same method, but this time with values you want to reset to. This value should be an object where the key is a control name, and it is what we define here when we build the form. And the value should be whatever value you want that fits the type, of course. But if it should be the same value as the value the user entered, then you would need to read this value from the appropriate form control. Something like that, right? But doing so for every control isn't flexible and efficient enough. So you can just provide a form value as an argument, because there the data is serialized precisely in the format we need. Now we can save this change and try it out again. One more time, I have to properly fill out the form which I'm about to submit, and you can see that the form control statuses have been reset, but values remain the same as I entered. And this is the second strategy in action. There also can be a third scenario when you want to give an option for your user to reset the form to some certain state, for instance, initial state. For that, you would probably add an additional button right next to the submit button, but this one will get the type reset. And let's maybe disable it when the form is pristine. And this type of button triggers the form event called reset in case if user clicks this button. And also let's add a CSS class to it. And in my global styles, I think I already have some styles for this kind of button in order to visually, you know, distinguish it from the save button. And now once we have such a button, we can listen for reset JavaScript event and handle it accordingly inside the onReset method that I have to obviously create and provide the native reset event as an argument for this callback. Inside this callback, we should again trigger the reset method as we did it when we submitted the form. And here let's reset the first name field to some value. So far it doesn't matter which exactly, it's just for testing purposes. So I save it, go to the browser, I'm going to click the reset button, and you can see that something strange has happened. It was reset to an empty value while we're expecting to have the reset test string. The problem here is the native behavior of the form when the reset event is fired. Despite form group directive handles the reset event as well, it doesn't prevent the native behavior, and this is exactly the reason why our value was wiped, even though we provided it for the reset form method. We can easily fix it by calling prevent default on the reset event. Now, if we go to the browser and try to click the reset button, you can see that the value was reset to what we defined in our callback. All right, now we can go back to the code and let's implement the feature that resets values to the initial state. The logic here is going to be quite simple. Somewhere here, I'm going to introduce a new property like initial form value. Regarding the type, let's keep it simple so far and use just any. Later, we will make it more strict. And then the logic is very simple. After we fetched the additional data for the form and built the appropriate form controls dynamically, then we can record the initial value of the built form and save it into this property we just created. After that, we could use this property as a parameter for the reset function in the onReset method. So like that, here we go. And by the way, the initial value we should update also when we submit the form, right? Because after the submission, the new value becomes kind of initial value before the next submission. And this is basically it. Now, if I go back to the form and modify some fields like that, then I reset the form and you can see that values were reset to the initial values. And if I try to fill out the form again, okay, it will take some time. And if I submit the form and after that I modify some field right here and try to reset the form again, then the form values were set to the state after the latest submission, which is exactly the behavior I expected. So let's quickly recap what we have learned. In order to reset the form using reactive forms, we have to call the reset method that is provided by the form group instance that represents the form. This method will reset values of all form controls to null, except non-valuable form controls. Then it resets the validation state and make controls untouched and pristine. However, it doesn't update the ng-submitted status for the form element. If it is important for you to reset that state as well, consider injecting the form group directive and calling the reset form method that will do the same, resetting, but this method will also reset the ng-submitted status. If you want to reset controls to some specific values, you can provide an object that matches the form control structure, respecting also grouping, and the object keys must match the form control names as well. If you want to handle the native JavaScript reset event, you have to call the prevent default method on this event, so it will not be handled by the native behavior of the form when the reset event is fired. If you want to reset the form to the initial form value, you can get a reference to the initial form values right after you build the form. And after that, you can provide this value as an argument for the reset method when you actually need it. This video is just a tiny part of my whole video course dedicated to advanced Angular forms, where in the same manner with diving deep into the source code and all those stuff, I try to explain different Angular forms features. So just take 1 minute to check out what you will learn from this course. In just a few easy sections, you will be guided through most of the template-driven and reactive forms features, so you can create two advanced and interactive forms that will impress everyone and leave you feel proud of your work. But that's not all. The course strongly focuses on custom form controls implementation, so you will learn a lot about control value accessor and how it is used by Angular under the hood. You will get to build custom form controls like a rating picker and a simple text editor, both of which support template-driven and reactive forms, as well as, you know, validations and other form control features, of course. In addition, you will master a really complex component in the third section. Here I'm talking about a drop-down component that supports option filtering, multi-selection, and accessible keyboard navigation. With my step-by-step guidance, you will be able to build this advanced form control very easy. Already impressive, isn't it? But even that is not all. In the remaining course sections, you will learn how to create Angular forms dynamically from JSON config and which architecture solution can help make it scalable and maintainable in the future. In the last section, you will learn how to manage validation errors globally, so you can dynamically render error messages for invalid controls without generating a ton of boilerplate in your component templates. So enroll right now and let's take your form building skills to a completely new level. The link to the course and discounts will be in the video description. Alright guys, that was it. I hope you enjoyed this video. I hope you will enjoy the course as well. Please subscribe to my channel if it is your first time here. Also check out my other videos. Subscribe to my social media. There I post different tips and tricks about Angular development and front-end in general, and I wish you productive week ahead, stay safe, and see you in the next video.